Before Notion charts were released, it was really difficult to gain insights from your Notion CRM data. You had to either create complex formulas in order to summarize data, or you had to summarize data in table views just like this, with having to go here and either count or summarize columns. But now with charts released, Notion has become one of the most affordable solutions as a CRM for both small businesses and solopreneurs. And there's fortunately new updates by Notion every single week that are making Notion more and more viable for business use cases. It can be difficult to know where to get started for getting insights out of a CRM, which is why I've put together 38 different Notion CRM charts that will help you better understand how your business is performing. Please note that at this time of filming, to get unlimited charts in your Notion workspace, you must have the Plus plan. If you're on a free plan, you can only build a couple of charts. In my opinion, the $10 per month is well worth it, especially when you compare Notion to other CRM alternatives on the market and their pricing and their capabilities. With that known, let's dive into the 38 different Notion charts that I've created, and I hope I can inspire you along the way to create some of your own. First off, I'm going to be covering opportunities, or also known as deals. These represent how much revenue your business is bringing in the CRM. So for charts for this, I recommend creating a one by month so that you can see the breakdown of your revenue by each month. And you typically want to go off like a close date field. This close date field, you want to make sure that you're marking whenever you won a deal to the date so that you can understand that this is how much we won this month, this is how much we won this quarter, or perhaps even this is how much we won this week. Generating sales pipeline is also very important for your business. So we want to make sure that we're creating an ample amount of deals every single month with businesses or B2C customers so that we can ultimately hit our revenue goal. So we definitely want to make sure that we're tracking month by month how many deals we're creating. And if we are somehow slow in one certain month, we need to make sure that we're picking up that number so that we can ultimately hit our goals. Closely aligned with created by month, we have open pipeline by month. It's not only important for your business to be tracking how you are performing for this current month or past months, it's also important to project out how much deal revenue you have potentially for future months and quarters. If you don't have much deal pipeline, it's really important for you to be going out and doing a lot of business development and finding more opportunities for your business so that you can hit your revenue goals. Next up, we have open pipeline by deal, which allows you to see each one of your individual deals that you are currently working and what is the piece of the pie that they are covering. So for example, I have two deals that are open here in this fake data CRM. And we have one that is for 5K, which is approximately 71% of my open pipeline. And then we have one that is for 2K, which is for around 29%. So this can help you really focus your attention on what are the biggest deals that your company is currently working on so that you can make sure that the right amount of attention is being provided to it. Next up, we have pipeline by owner, which is really important to understand how are your sales reps performing in generating opportunities for your company. As you can see here, I am only at that 2K percentage compared to Mary Kate. So as a sales rep, I should be going out and really making sure that I am pursuing new opportunities, cold calling, email, etc., so that I can kind of try to catch up with the same amount of pipeline as my fellow sales rep. Then we have repeat versus new business. Repeat and renewal are interchangeable. And over time, most businesses find that those renewal type of customers are going to be providing most of their revenue versus going out and getting new business, as new business deals are typically harder to close. So overall, you want to be looking at this chart and making sure with your existing customer base, you're not having much churn. And overall, this repeat business number continues to grow. Next up, we're going to be discussing charts for products and services, which are closely aligned to deals. So starting off here, I have a revenue by product chart that allows us to see overall in the history of the company, how much revenue has been won by each one of the products that we offer. Obviously, if you're winning more revenue with a certain product, such as I am here with the OptiOpp CRM, you probably want to have more attention towards supporting and providing enhancements for that product. So not only can you see the revenue per each product, but overall, you're just able to see with all of your products combined, how much revenue you've won for your business. Next up, similar to revenue by product, we have open pipeline by product. So these are products that are associated with deals in the pipeline that have not been won or lost yet. And this can be really important to tell exactly which products we're really relying on to secure revenue in the future. Then we have lost revenue by product, which if we're noticing that we're having one of our products more often associated to lost deals, then maybe we really need to look at it and determine we need to make some improvements here, or if it's a service, maybe you need to improve how you're offering your service. Then we have discount percentage by product. Ignore this huge number here. I just entered in some bigger numbers to make this look a little bit better while I'm presenting it. But it's really important for your business to be tracking how much you're discounting every time that you're winning deals, so you can ultimately find what is the right price point when we're selling this product or service. Next up, we have accounts, which represents companies that are within your CRM. Similar to deals, it's really important to have a healthy flow of account creation every single month so that you know that you are continuing to be out there and interacting and meeting with new companies. So here you can see in August 2024, I created 6, and then October 2024, created 2. This next one is one of my favorites, and it is lifetime value by account. And this is really important so that we can tell who are our customers who have given us the most revenue. And most likely the ones who are giving you the most revenue are your most loyal and the ones that you should be really paying attention to and providing the best product or service to them as possible. So as we can see here, Green Solutions brings up 65% of the revenue for this fake data that I have in the CRM. Google brings out 33, and then Meta is at 1.5. So obviously really want to be focusing my attention on Green Energy Solutions and Google and making sure they're happy. Another really important metric to track is how much revenue your business is bringing in per lead source. So as we can see here, we have 4K from a trade show, we have 2K from a paid ad, and then we have $90 for social media. So we want to take a look at our different lead sources, see what the conversion rates are, how much revenue they're bringing in, ultimately how much spend we have on each one of those lead sources, and the return on investment to over time help us optimize our marketing strategy to increase that return on investment and make sure that our efforts are going into the right places. Then finally, we have companies by relationship. So for most companies, majority of the accounts inside of your CRM are going to be in the prospect relationship. Then you also are going to have a good majority in the customer. Another examples of relationships are partners, competitors, and so on. Being able to filter out by what is the relationship, for example, if you're sending a product update only to customers, making sure this status of relationship is really nice and maintained can be helpful for those types of things. Now I'm going to move on to contacts charts. And similar to deals and to accounts, again, we want to make sure that we're having a healthy stream of contacts that are created with their phone number and with their email. And this chart's going to allow you to be able to see month by month how many you're creating. So if you're kind of getting towards the end of the month and you're a little bit low on that number, make sure you kind of bump it up and increase the number of contacts that you're trying to reach out at a time. Then we have created by. So it's important to check for everyone in your system who's creating the most contacts and ultimately who's reaching out to the most every single month. Then we have by type. So examples of type are they're the main contact for the company, or they're the decision maker, or they're just an end user who is sitting on a few calls with you and ultimately isn't going to be the one who makes the decision. So important to make sure for each one of your contacts in your system, you're giving them a different type so that you can understand their role within their company. And then another important data point to be tracking is what is the status of each one of the contacts that you're working with? Are they a customer, or is one of your sales reps currently working with them? Or did they just enter the system and they're only a lead and you don't know much information about them? Or have you talked to them, their company doesn't have a budget, or they don't understand at all the product or service you're selling and isn't even the type of role that would be a fit? Then you'd move them to unqualified. So right now we just have 8 different contacts in this fake data CRM, but ultimately you could imagine you would be able to get a really good picture of how good your prospecting is for finding new contacts to introduce to your CRM. Moving on to projects, it's really good to have, again, that created by month. What is the completed by month, and who is the owner who completed them? Who has the most projects and their name? And then for completed by owner, just getting the full picture of the entire history of your CRM, who has completed the most projects. And then for projects, what is their status? So how many have you completed? How many are you currently planning for? How many are in progress? And so on. For tasks, again, we want to see that created by month and be able to see the owner. Then how many of those created tasks are we completing by month to be able to show us how productive our team is being. And then we can drill down on that even further by looking at completed this week, completed today, which I haven't completed a task here in the system today, but you can imagine there would be one if I move the status to done. How many tasks are in your users' names? So you can see we have 5 open tasks total, 3 in my name, 2 in Mary's. And over time, as you use the system and there's a lot of tasks, you could have a user that ends up having way too many tasks in your name. And you're like, are you actually still working on these? If not, please move all the statuses to done for me. Then lastly, for tasks, we have it by status. So seeing if it's in progress, if it's not been started, or how many tasks have been completed in your system over time. And the last database that we're going to be analyzing with charts is going to be support cases, which just represents if one of your customers is having an issue, them creating a case with you and your team ultimately resolving it for them and tracking how long that takes. This one's kind of unique because unlike the others, we most likely do not want a lot of support cases being created because that means most likely you're having issues with your products or services. But it's really important for us to be tracking this data so that you can see how many issues you're having and understand what you need to do to make sure that we're making the customer experience a lot better. So yeah, here we have open by month and then we have closed by month. So how often your reps are closing each one of those cases that come up as they arise. Who on your support team has the most cases in their name? Because if one of your individuals on the support team has more cases in their name than another person, then you probably want to be assigning cases to the person with the least amount so that they can resolve things faster. Close by owner, so you can see how productive your support reps are being. Then we have support cases by type, so you can understand in your company where issues are most often arising. So just for some examples here, I have maybe it's a product related issue, or someone's giving you feedback, or perhaps it's like a billing issue, like a credit card issue. Then drilling down even deeper on each type, you can have subtypes that allow you to, for example, if it's a billing issue, I have it's a billing dispute or a payment issue underneath that tree. So subtypes allow you to just really drill down on your data and really understand what is the issues that you're most commonly experiencing. Then we have support cases by account, and this is going to allow you to understand by each company who are experiencing the most issues, who should be having the most attention focused to, or in some cases, this can kind of help you identify maybe these guys are some problem accounts. Maybe we really need to rethink our strategy of how we interact with them. Then for our last of our 38 different charts for a Notion CRM, support cases by status, just so you can track, you know, how many have been completed over time, how many are in progress, and how many are not started. Now, for some of you who are new to my YouTube channel, you're probably wondering, you know, how are you getting charts? What is the data that you're analyzing here? One of the most important things to be able to get use out of your Notion workspace is you got to have a strong data model foundation. I use my years of CRM consulting experience to build these databases inside of Notion that our charts are ultimately looking at. In this instance, this CRM is using a similar data model to Salesforce, which has been the most used CRM in the world for many years now. If you don't know where to get started for creating a CRM in Notion, I have both a free version and a paid version on my website that I'll be linking in the description below. I also have a video on the same channel that shows you how to build a Notion CRM from scratch. Keep in mind that for the paid version, it took me many, many hours to put it together, and the charts alone took at least 3 hours. So that one-time purchase, I think, is definitely worth it, in my opinion. That's it for my video on Notion CRM charts. Hope it can inspire you to create some of your own. And for more Notion business content just like this, make sure to subscribe, and it would be awesome if you gave this video a like. Thank you.